Hi everyone, my name is Elena Martin and I'm a PhD student at the University of La Laguna, Spain. Thank you very much for your interest in this work, which is focused on a multi-ancestry epigenome-wide associated study of asthma exacerbations. As we know, patients with asthma may experience episodic outbreaks or attacks known as exacerbations. Severe exacerbations are especially important, which involve the administration of systemic corticosteroids, visit to the emergency room, or hospitalizations in the last year. Asthma exacerbation is a complex character and results from the interaction of environmental and genetic factors. Although several genetic markers have been identified for asthma exacerbations, the effects of the interaction with environmental factors remain unclear, and this could be captured by epigenetic modifications. Although there are different types of epigenetic mechanisms, DNA methylation is the most commonly studied. Recently, the first epigenome-wide association study, or EWAS, of asthma exacerbations revealed epigenetic biomarkers in Europeans. To improve our understanding of asthma exacerbation genetics across different populations, the main objective of this study was to identify changes in DNA methylation associated with asthma exacerbations in minoritized admixed populations from the United States. Regarding the results, the most significant CPG identified in minoritized and admixed populations was a CPG annotated to the MKRN2 gene. This gene encodes a ubiquitin E3 ligase that promotes the degradation of the P65 subunit of the pro-inflammatory transcription factor NF-kappa-B, affecting NF-kappa-B-mediated inflammatory responses. Interestingly, epigenetic variation at this gene has been previously associated with fractional exhaled nitric oxide or FeNO levels in nasal samples from children. On the other hand, three CPGs previously associated with asthma exacerbations in Europeans were replicated in the multi-ancestry meta-EWAS. Furthermore, we identified a novel association for a CPG annotated to the USP7 gene. This ubiquitinating enzyme, ubiquitin-specific protease, participates in the differentiation of functional Th2 cells involved in chronic allergic inflammation, including asthma, by regulating signal transducers and activators of transcription. Interestingly, nasal DNA methylation levels at this CPG have been previously associated with pediatric asthma and FeNO levels. Significant CPGs in the multi-ancestry meta-EWAS were selected to test the association between their methylation levels and normalized gene expression levels of nearby genes. The integration of epigenetic and gene expression data revealed that DNA methylation at this CPG was associated with lower FKBP5 expression. This result is supported by previous findings where relative hypomethylation at this CPG was associated with asthma and FKBP5 expression in nasal samples from African patients, showing a stronger association with severe asthma. FKBP5 gene encodes a component of the glucocorticoid receptor, which regulates its responses to glucocorticosteroids, the first-line therapy to control airway inflammation in asthma. Finally, we identified 22 significant differentially methylated regions, or DMRs, associated with asthma exacerbations in minoritized and mixed populations. From this, the genomic region of three CPGs annotated to the WD repeat domain 4 was consistent using an independent method and showed a stronger association in the multi-ancestry meta-analysis. WDR4 encodes a subunit of a methyltransferase complex, and its expression levels have been linked to lung cancer. Moreover, DNA methylation in this gene has been associated with the body mass index in children and with different environmental exposures, although the role in asthma is unknown. I want to thank my team, Genomics and Health Group, and all our collaborators and funders who made this study possible. Thank you very much.